Welcome to this introductory video on SAM.gov Ad Hoc Contract Data Reports. In this video, we will go over the basic principles of ad hoc reporting, review who can create ad hoc reports, and do a quick overview of the ad hoc reporting tool in the SAM.gov website. If you are not sure what ad hoc reporting is, or if it's something you could benefit from using, keep watching, as this short video will answer some common questions about ad hoc reporting. Before we begin, if you are not already familiar with the SAM.gov data bank, please view our video on standard, static, and admin reports to get oriented to finding reports on the site. As with standard reports, only DoD users can see the most recent 90 days of data on DoD-funded contracts. Let's start with the reasons to use ad hoc reporting. Simply put, ad hoc reporting can be used anytime you know what kind of information you are looking for. You can use the ad hoc reporting tool when you want to create a report with information specific to your needs. For example, you would want to use an ad hoc report when one of the standard or static reports does not show exactly the data that you are looking for. And anyone with an account on SAM.gov can use the ad hoc reporting tool. So, if you've decided that an ad hoc report is what you need, let's go over what information you should have in order to successfully build your ad hoc report. Building an ad hoc report without a clear idea of what data you are trying to see will be difficult. That's why we recommend you gather the answers to these three questions before you begin building your report. 1. What time period are you interested in? A certain fiscal year? A certain month in a year? As a side note, be aware that 12 years is the maximum range you can retrieve in the reporting tool. 2. What data do you want your report to include? Do you know how you'd like to categorize that data and what measures you want to include in your report? And 3, if you need to, how would you like to filter your report? Is there a specific vendor you want to filter for? Or a specific state that you want to focus on? Or a dollar amount that you're looking for? Once you have the answers to these questions, you are ready to start building your ad hoc report. Before you begin, we do want to point out that some experience using advanced reporting tools will make it easier to build these reports. However, this experience is not required. If you are new to ad hoc reporting, don't worry. We've created some tutorial videos to help you get started building ad hoc reports. For the last part of this video, we'll go over what an ad hoc report looks like and what the reporting tool interface looks like to get you more comfortable with the new reporting tool. Let's start with the basic anatomy of a report. Here we have a basic ad hoc report. There is a lot of information, so let's break it down into pieces. On the top of the report, we have what are called attributes and metrics. Attributes are the aspect of the contract you are interested in. For example, you might be interested in which department issued the contracts or what type of vendors they were awarded to. Then on the right side, we have a metric column. Metrics are measures or quantitative data points. In this case, dollars obligated is our metric. We also have view filters in our report. These filters allow us to narrow down the data that we're looking at. In this case, we have narrowed our report down to show only the top 10 contracts by dollars obligated. Finally, we have a row count, which shows us how many rows our report has. As a quick heads up, the tool limits users to 150,000 rows of data. Now that we have a general idea of what a report looks like, let's quickly give you an idea of what the report building interface looks like before you jump in. The tool might look daunting at first, so we're going to break it down piece by piece. Let's start on the left side. We have two folders in the Reports panel. The Schema Objects folder contains all of our attributes, those aspects of the contract that we're interested in. NASA users should be aware that NASA-specific attributes are found here as well, and they are only visible to NASA users. Right above that folder, we have the Public Objects folder, which contains all of our metrics, which is what we want to measure about those attributes. You can switch between those two folders using the top folder panel. We'll explore how that works in our tutorials. The center area of the interface is our report building space. As we add attributes and metrics to the report, they will show up in this space. We can move attributes and metrics around in our report so that they show up in the order that we want them to. In the top panel, we have our report filters. If we want to narrow our report down based on specific attributes or metrics, we can do so by dragging them to this panel. Again, we'll go over how to do all these things in our tutorials. Lastly, we wanted to point out the Run the Report button in the top left-hand corner of the page. When we have built our report and filtered it to our specific needs, we can run the report and retrieve the data we're looking for. That's all we'll cover here today. If you are ready to start building ad hoc reports, please check out our other tutorial videos. We'll go over how to create ad hoc reports for all user experience levels. We strongly recommend that you watch them and follow along so you get a better understanding of how to use the tool and how to best build your reports. Remember, you can search the Federal Service Desk Knowledge Base for additional videos and frequently asked questions, or get help with technical issues at fsd.gov. To provide GSA feedback about features, functionalities, or the user experience in sam.gov, click the feedback button located at the bottom of each page.